with you. The reason why I put down these two slides is because, again, many patients ask me these few questions. The first question is, okay, if I cannot have table sugar, can I eat honey? Can I use honey, you know, or gula melaka? It's not white color, or brown sugar, or rock sugar. You know, it's not powder, it's rock. Can I use that instead? I have one patient who went to see me a few years ago, gestational diabetic. So which means she found out she's diabetic during pregnancy, and I told her, be careful, you know, I planned a diet for her. 2 days later, she called me. She said, oh, Pauline, I follow exactly what you told me, but my sugar went even higher. Why is it so? I said, cannot be, because if you follow my plan, your sugar cannot be higher. So I said, okay, besides what, you know, I told you to eat, is there anything else that you're eating that you forgot to tell me? Then she thought for a while. She said, oh, yeah, I forgot to tell you. Every morning, I drink honey water. Maybe that's the reason why. I said, why are you drinking honey water? Oh, you know, towards the end of the pregnancy, got constipation, right? So friends told her, drink honey water, help to relieve constipation. So every morning, honey water. I said, no wonder your sugar went up. But she said, it's honey, it's not sugar. When it goes into you, your system, it doesn't matter whether it's in the form of honey or sugar or the rock sugar, it's the same thing to us. So if you cannot have sugar, you have uncontrolled diabetes, you also should avoid honey, gula melaka, brown sugar or rock sugar. Okay. The other so-called frequently asked questions by our patients is, oh, if I eat a lot of sugary food, would that cause diabetes? Would that cause diabetes? I have one patient, again, gestation diabetic, came to see me. The husband told me, complain and say, it's all her fault. I told her not to eat so much mooncake. See that now she got diabetes because she eat too much mooncake. Is it because of the mooncake? Okay, consumption of very high sugar food does not directly lead to diabetes. However, if you consume a lot and you become overweight, that is one of the risk factors for diabetes. That would increase the risk of you having diabetes. So indirectly, that would. But directly, no linkage. But once you discover that you're diabetic, you must control, okay? So the strategic eating plan for individuals with diabetes, very simple. Control your calories, balance it with exercise, to your medication, and make sure that you balance it out with the right amount of carbohydrates, because that would affect your sugar the most. And you make sure that you balance your carbohydrates and you spread out your carbohydrates throughout the day. That would definitely help you to control your blood sugar level. And with that, okay, I just wanted to have this last slide, okay, to make sure that you try to match your food preferences, your lifestyle, your medication regime. And if you don't know how to do it, get your dietitian, you know, to help you to plan an individualized meal plan, because that would significantly improve your sugar control. Okay, with that, I finished my presentation, but I'm just going to steal 1 minute to explain to you about potassium, because Dr. Chong just now mentioned that. I will explain to you about potassium. Today's focus is on diabetes, so that's why I didn't actually address the issue related to her potassium. But since she highlighted that in her presentation, I thought that maybe I would just share with you what kind of foods are very high in potassium. Most of us Asians, Singaporeans, get our potassium from fruits and vegetables. Okay, a lot of fruits and vegetables are very high in potassium. For example, orange, banana, durian, okay, your honeydew, okay, your peach, your mango are very high in potassium. In terms of vegetables, which one has the highest? Spinach. Spinach very high. What else? Kai lan, chai sum, cauliflower, broccoli. Chinese mushroom, the dry black color mushroom, all very high in potassium. So for those diabetic patients who have problem with potassium, who have high potassium level, you really need to pay attention. You need to know what kind of vegetables, what kind of foods to choose. Okay? And one more thing, do not soak your tea bag for too long, because if you soak it for too long, potassium will soak into your, will leak out and then go into your tea. So when you go and drink it, it'll be quite high in potassium. So just dip it a few times, you get a color, get a taste, throw away the tea bag. Don't soak it for too long. Don't use too much coffee powder. Okay? With that, I finish my presentation. Thank you very much.